Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So this is my third time filming this intro. Okay, so I filmed it the first time and I kind of changed the direction of the video, so I deleted that one. The second time I did not hit play, so it wasn't recording. Now is the third time, so let's get it right. So in this video, I'm going to be putting in braids, kind of like a protective style kind of vibe. I wanted to do a braid out, but I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to do a protective style. I put four on this side, four on this side, just because it's easy, simple, not time consuming. We are done. So this has been a video I wanted to film for a long time. I actually did film it, but I ended up deleting it because when I was editing it was like my thoughts were all over the place. I still couldn't know how to process the whole thing and kind of express the whole thing. It was just, it's a heavy topic. It's just heavy, and it's just, I was still processing my whole emotion around everything that happened. The George Floyd video, the Brianna case, the Ahmed case, all of that is just too heavy. That's all we're going to talk about in this video. So yeah, I'm going to jump into it, braid my hair, show you guys the product I'm using, and then we'll talk. Also, one thing is I'm not good at expressing myself verbally. I kind of do write than talk. So it's not like I'm like a great writer or anything. I just kind of know how to put my thoughts in text or on paper than actually say it out. I don't know if that makes sense, but if it's weird, welcome to my weird world. In this video, I try as much as possible to express myself, so I really just want to put that out there before we start the video. So let's start the video. I'm not going to be doing perfect sides. I really don't do that. I really don't care of the mess. I just do what I feel like. So I sectioned this part into two. I'm going to be doing two on each section, maybe three at the front, depending on how I can get my edges in, but the goal is to do two each per section. So that's what we are going to be doing. I will be using my aloe vera juice. I made a new one, and then I will be using the Dove Amplified Texture Moisture Lock Leave-In. And I'll also be using the TGIN Buttercream Daily Moisturizer. Yep. And then I'll be using the Wetline Extreme Gel a little bit on my ends, just to keep my ends intact, because that's the most frizziest part of my hair. And then I'll seal in with my aloe vera oil. So that's what we are going to be doing. Going to open everything up so it will be easy to apply them. So this past couple of weeks has been very, very tough. There's a lot happening in the world now, and it saddens my heart that this will be happening at this point in life. You would think like we'll be at a point that we'll move past these things, like the color of your skin determine the kind of things that you can and cannot do at a place. It's sad, but that's the reality of what is happening. And I have watched George Floyd's video, may his soul rest in peace, and it was the saddest video that I have to watch in my entire life. Like, I couldn't watch that video over and over again. I've heard of Ahmed's case, but I didn't quite hear of Brianna's case before George Floyd's case came in. So I heard of Brianna after George's incident happened, and it was heartbreaking. It's like you are not even safe in your own home, and it's just like you don't know when this can be you. You know, these are people that look like you, people that think like you, and it's just like because of the color of your skin, things like this have to happen to you, and it's really bad. I think we need to change as people. We need to change as a country, We need to change as a world. Like, everybody needs to do their part. And there are a lot of people that when you say Black Lives Matter, it kind of like, they just don't get it. They make statements like all life matter and all of those things. Yes, all life matter, we get it. Like, we all get that every life is important. But the thing is, I'm going to be using a pen rod to curl the end so that it will be intact. So it's just like, some people's life has been taken seriously, some other community a haven't, and that's what the whole Black Lives Matter movement is all about. It's not saying Black Lives Matter does not mean that other lives don't matter. It's just that other lives has been taken seriously except Black lives. Black people are killed, they are discriminated against, they don't have jobs. It's like, the fact that you are Black and you walk into an organization, you have to think of everything the moment you walk into that organization. The way you talk, the way you're walking, the way you dress, everything is being judged about you. And nobody have to live in such condition, you know. And it's just, we just have to start doing better now. I've just, this whole thing has opened my eyes to a lot of things and a lot of research. And one thing that I've been learning from this whole thing is how Black people are not being taken seriously when it comes to healthcare. It's like, when you go to a hospital and a Black person is in pain, they don't believe them. It's like the system just make it harder for Black people to succeed or to leave, if I should put it like that. And it's just hard for somebody who wants to get into medicine. That saddens my heart. And it's just, I just feel like every little change that somebody can do towards this is going to be something, you know. I'm putting a little bit of the gel. So yeah, and if you happen to be around somebody who doesn't understand this, I think it's just best that you educate the person. But I don't think it's also best that you force your beliefs on somebody. Yes, people are open to learning, but if the person is not open to learning, I just think just let it go. It's really not worth it. I'll also make sure to leave the organizations in the description. If you have any donation, be sure to donate to them. And also support Instagram pages that are bringing awareness to this thing, like Pull Up or Shut Up. I just found out about that, and it's just like a lot of companies are geared towards Black communities, but these companies have less employees that are Black. The last time I was watching a video about these hair companies that are geared towards Black people, like, who do you sell your wigs to? Who do you sell your extensions to? Most of this wigs and extensions are being sold to Black people, and these extension and wig companies don't acknowledge Black people like that. Like, you go into their businesses and you can barely find Black people in there, and it's sad. And this whole Black Lives Matter thing going on, it's just like this, these companies even are reluctant to even post something about it or say something about it. They have to be called out before they say something about it. You don't have to wait for somebody to call you out before you be like, oh, we will do better next time. No, like, it's just, Black people are just degraded in every level, even when it comes to like being an influencer or things like that. Even at jobs, like Black people are paid less than white people. If you're an influencer and you're being offered a campaign and you're Black, most of these campaigns, they end up paying their white workers more than Black workers, and it shouldn't be like that. And sometimes this the Black influencer even end up driving a lot of traffic to these companies that are geared to Black people, but they don't want to contribute to Blackness. And I am finally happy that some sort of justice has been served in this Judge Floyd's case, and this police are at least taken into custody, and we know the charges for one of them but not the others, which I think the others still need to serve some jail time. It's just inhuman that you can be standing there for somebody's life to be taken and you don't see anything. Like, that bothers me. The whole video, his knee on his neck bothered me, and the other police just standing there watching him and not doing anything, that even made me angry more. And I think all of them need to be punished. And I'm also happy that they are taking some action for Brianna's case, but I still do think that some sort of justice needs to be served in her case as well, not just no knock warrant thing. I just think that some sort of action needs to be taken too, for justice to be served. So yeah, like I said, I'll leave the organization in the description if you want to donate. I'm going to start fast forwarding this so we can get through this video real quick. That's all I want to say. Just let all of us be better human beings. Let's do better. Let's support each other. The color of our skin shouldn't bring division in us. And you supporting the Black Lives Matter movement doesn't mean that you are neglecting other lives. And if you're white and you're supporting the Black Lives Movement, it does not make you less of a human being. This is just what we are facing as a nation and a country, and it just needs to be solved. Some people's lives are not taken seriously, and people that are supposed to protect us are not even protecting us. Racism in any form or any way is bad. Small, big, is bad. And it hurts. If you're not Black, you don't know how it feels like. I have experienced a little bit of racism, not to the extreme, and it really hurts. And it's just like, sometimes all of those things affect you psychologically. I remember one time I was pulled over by the police, and I was in fear. The whole time I was praying in my head, and it was just, you are constantly living in that fear. You shouldn't have to live in that fear. Even maybe it's the good police that pulled you over, you're still going to be living in some sort of fear until you kind of realize, okay, I'm out of the danger. Nobody have to live like that. And it's just that I feel like everybody needs to do their part. We all need to be better, especially if you're racist and you were against Black people, and you just think that the color of your skin makes you superior over somebody. I think you need to be changing your mindset. You need to do some sort of checking in here, and you need to check yourself. Sit down, you know, count your privileges and see why somebody else is screaming Black Lives Matter, because you don't have to go through those things. You don't have to think when the police stop you. You don't have to think of whether you're gonna get that job interview when you're walking. You don't have to think that, oh, the color of your skin is the problem why you think you don't have to do this or you didn't get that, you know. So just, if you're somebody, you have a racist past, you can change now. You know, there's always time to change. There's always time to correct the mistakes in the past. I think we should all just be better, and this world would be a better place. And yeah, so I'm finally done. This is what I have. Of course, my edges are rough. because they are broken. This is how the back looked like. I don't think it's very organized at all, but I don't mind. And I've changed my mind. I'm not going to take them down. I'm just going to keep it in like a protective style kind of way. Just because, one, I don't want to take it down. And two, I just realized I didn't comb it up when I was doing it. That is very key when you're doing the braid out or the twist out. It's very good to comb out your hair. Or like comb it when you put the product in, or maybe before the product, something like that, to make sure your hair is very, very detangled, or else when you're separating it, it's gonna create frizz and you're gonna have knots in it. So make sure it's very, very knotless. So yeah, that's what we have. I like this. I'll probably take the primrose off before I go to bed and just maintain it like this. I think this will even make my life easier. So I'm not going to be talking too much. This video is already long. So like I said, let's all do better. And also check the description for any more information. And I'll catch you in my next video. So until then, stay blessed and beautiful.